we brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are his everlasting arms. By faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother David for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother David. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth, until by your call we are united with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As we come to give God thanks and praise for the life and witness for our brother David, let us begin by singing the hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine.
Thank you.
appreciate. At this time, we have tribute by Andrew Boyce. This will be followed by eulogy by David Gibbons.
A blessed good morning to the church. My name is Andrew Boyce, and on behalf of my family, I wish to extend sincere condolences to the family and the loved ones of our dearly departed brother. And I say thanks as well to the family for affording me this opportunity to share this tribute with you. It is a privilege, and it really is an honor to be able to share this with you. And I say an honor because when I first arrived in Bermuda in 1979, it was him more than anyone else who helped me to settle in. He had been there for 11 years, so he knew the lay of the land, and he was able to guide me and help me to settle in and make those cultural and other adjustments that I needed to make in order to settle in. So I'll be eternally grateful for him. And I've always considered him since then as my big brother. So today I'm sharing with you a tribute which was sent in, one of the many, many tributes that was sent in from overseas by his former colleagues and friends. And the family has chosen this one, which was sent by the Commissioner of Police in Bermuda, who's also my dear good friend and former work colleague. And he writes, "Dear family and friends, I write on behalf of the Bermuda Police Service to express my condolences at the passing of Mr. David Gibbons. Sergeant Gibbons, as he was known to me, was one of my first sergeants. He was a difficult taskmaster. He set high standards and made sure we all kept them. He was always barking at us, but it didn't take long to realize that he was deeply concerned and interested in our progress. Fortunately, his bark was almost always followed by a large, infectious, toothy grin. After all, he had a big heart. Sergeant Gibbons knew everyone, and everyone knew him. He was good at his job and trusted in the community. People would come to the station and ask for him by name. He was the only one they trusted. Most conversations would start with, 'Who are your people?' Clearly, establishing family connections was just as important as the business of the day. He could easily be relied on to know most persons' families and how we were connected. He relished in the fact that he knew more about my family and connections than I did, and took great pleasure in reminding me of this whenever we came into contact with one of my distant relatives. He consistently asked about my family, how we were doing, and what we were up to. He took a genuine interest in my well-being. His work and travels with the JCs were a constant topic, and any spare moment he had, especially during night shift, he would try to convince me to join. Sergeant Gibbons set a foundation for me in my policing career. Through his leadership, I learned most of the job basics, which was people, paperwork, patrol, and prisoners. He set me on a good path that, without a doubt, contributed to where I am today. Bermuda owes a debt of gratitude to Sergeant Gibbons for his 32 years of faithful, dedicated service to our community. I owe a debt of gratitude to Sergeant Gibbons for his support and mentoring. He will be fondly remembered. My prayer is that you will find a measure of comfort in your fond memories of David, and as you partake in the fellowship among family and friends that these difficult times often bring. May God bless you all. And that's written by Darren Simons, Commissioner of Police in Bermuda. So rest in peace, big brother. Until we meet again, rest in peace.
Good morning, all. David Andrew Gibbons was born on the 18th of September, 1945, to Muriel Gibbons and the late Oscar Walker. He was raised by his grandmother, the late Ada Gibbons, also known as Mammy. He attended All Saints School and then attended Fever High School to further his education. David was the oldest of his siblings, which included five brothers, Henry, Argyle, Adrian, Jerry, and Pearson, and four sisters, Bonita, Marva, Linda, and Patricia. David was an avid reader and always had a thirst for knowledge. He worked at the Treasury Department of the Barbados government before joining the Bermuda Police as a young constable on the 14th of March, 1968. He attended basic training course number 10, being one of six officers recruited in Barbados, together with Bermudian recruits, several of whom had passed through cadet training. Following graduation, David served for 18 months in Western Division prior to transferring to Central Division from August 1969 until June 1971, at which time he was posted on Mobile Reserve. David was introduced to fatherhood with the birth of his daughter Pamela on the 30th of November, 1969. In 1972, David was appointed Parish Constable for Pembroke East until his transfer to Eastern Division in 1975. David was married in 1974 to the former Arlene Maynard. This union produced two children, David in 1976 and Dawn in 1981. He was promoted to sergeant in January of 1979. Whilst in Eastern Division, where he was appointed divisional clerk in 1982 and became a watch sergeant, sergeant number 43, in Eastern Division in 1987. David was awarded his Long Service and Good Conduct Medal in 1986 and served as Supreme Court officer until his retirement in September 2000. Due to his competitive nature, he loved to engage in board games with family and friends. These include Scrabble, Password, and Monopoly. David was eager to play the role of the banker. These sessions were intense and would go on for hours. He loved photography and could be seen with a camera always at the ready. His daughters shared in that same pursuit. David believed in service before self and could be seen helping others, whether it was mentoring young people in the police service or teaching Bible studies. David was well known in the community and respected by many. David was very knowledgeable and loved engaging in debates on various topics. He loved history and geography, as such, invested much time improving his vast appreciation for the subjects. He had subscriptions to National Geographic and various political magazines such as The Economist. He also enjoyed reading international newspapers. David had a green thumb, and anything he planted would flourish. Mustard greens to pumpkins, peppers to pawpaws, Sugarcane to loquats are a few items that David was able to cultivate. David was not afraid of hard work and was diligent at any task before him. He was always giving 100%, often encouraging others to do the same. His passport was filled with stamps from numerous countries. David was fortunate to travel to 6 of the 7 continents. Through the JCs, he traveled to Asia, which includes China, Japan, the Pacific Islands, Hawaii, and Fiji, also Australia and New Zealand, and in Europe, Denmark, Germany, Holland, Scotland, and England, through South America, including Belize and Colombia, North America, which is Canada and the USA, and throughout the Caribbean. Life is a journey, and on this journey, there are smooth roads and potholes, there are hills and valleys. It is a journey that we all will have to take. David has come to the end of his journey. May he rest in eternal peace.
Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of faith, in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We now have our scripture reading, first Bible reading by Don Gibbons. And this will be followed by Psalm 46.
Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, unto the church of God, which is Corinth, and all saints, which are all Achaia. Grace be to you, peace from God our Father, from the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be God, even our Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who cometh forth us in all tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble, by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. For us, the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abundeth by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same sufferings which we also suffer, or whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. And our hope is of you is steadfast, knowing that as ye are partakers of the sufferings, so shall be ye also of consolation.
Amen.
now have our second Bible reading, and this will be done by Tamara Griffith. And this will be followed by the hymn, Immortal, Invisible.
A reading from the Word of God, from 2 Philippians verses 5-7. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. This is the word of the Lord.
That is made to each of us to use our skills
all intellect, and all compassion to serve others. Joshua, after gathering the tribes of Israel together, he said to his leaders, respect the Lord and serve him in sincerity and faithfulness. In the Psalms, David reminds his people, the Lord ransoms the life of his servants, and none will punish who trust in him. In Ephesians, Paul challenges his listeners to put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. The remarkable thing in the Gospel of John is that the disciples have questioned Jesus about his teaching on the Eucharist and what is required of those who follow him. Many turned back and no longer went with him. John called them, those who walked away from him, disciples. But these folks were committed to Christ, at least for a while, until things got a little tough and demanding beyond their understanding. Like many of us, we are honored to be a member of an organization until we have some heart-wrenching decision to make. The disciples became anxious about Jesus. They might have said, we like him, but can we do what he is asking? Jesus called the 12 together and asked them point blank, do you also wish to go away? Had we then been Jesus, how would we have asked that question? Would we have asked it sadly, disappointed by what had just took place? As individuals then, my friends, think of the tough decisions that we have had to make in business, at home, in social clubs, in our workplaces, or even in the church. How have we reached or reacted when questionable decisions that affect others? Most of the times, we are uncomfortable. We may feel like getting up and leaving the room. It is a normal reaction. But it is gracious to stay and listen. We need to be part of the solution. It's the only thing. Can we be at peace? Jesus knew what he was asking of his disciples. He knew what the cost would be, his life. He knew that what he was saying offended them, and they were unwilling to really hear what he was saying. Peter even later asked him, if this is so, Lord, to whom then shall we go? And Peter just could not grasp that Jesus would be with him in spirit as powerfully as he was in the flesh. Are not we, as active as we may be in the life of the church, often like this? Sometimes we are ashamed if you have to tell others about the love of Jesus. Yes, Jesus admittedly had an advantage over modern Christians. And he knew who were the ones that did not believe and who would betray him. You and I, we don't have that luxury. What we do have is the element of surprise. The Holy Spirit works through us as we share the love of Jesus with others. Sometimes, no matter how strong our convictions are, or how great our desire to journey with Christ may be, we may want to walk away to find a spot in the wilderness, away from the pressures of life around us. Peter doesn't just come out and tell Jesus that is what he wants to do, but Peter is honest about his uncertainty, and he realizes that no one besides Jesus is in the business of eternal life. Either the disciples of Jesus must keep his faith experience alive, or he will die away for the simple reason there's no other alternative. And so, Paul as the shield of faith. And that should be carried by those who go out to preach the gospel of Christ. Paul adds that faith is always the complete trust in Jesus Christ. Faith that a 5-year-old girl had when her grandmother asked her the question. And that little girl told Jesus, "Do you?" And she said, "Because Jesus is a friend." What a joy it will be then, my friends, when we all get to heaven and find our name on the roll of servant ministry. How has God empowered us as individuals to reach out and serve God by serving others in Jesus' name? One great theologian by the name of William Barclay, in his commentary, he reminds us that the sign of the Christian is when he or she is eager to be on their way to tell the story of Jesus, the death, his resurrection, and his ascension. This is the commitment of being a servant for the Lord. And he also went on to emphasize that for servant ministry, there are 3 main conditions that people must have in their prayer life. First, prayer must be constant. It is from daily prayer that we find daily strength and holy guidance. Prayer must be intense. No beating around the bush. When you have a clear message from the Lord about a particular concern, be bold about your prayer life. Be the prayer warrior he has called you to be. Prayer must be unselfish. We must learn that to pray as much for others as for ourselves. We must seek a community of believers to pray with us and for us. And together, we will know the wisdom of the Holy Spirit as it uses us to be the vehicle of servant ministry. My friends, we all need to find our gift of servant ministry. And I urge you to join the winning side. Tell others in our workplaces, where we live or play or go to school in just another couple weeks from now, that we want them to join the winning side. Tell them about Jesus, our friend. And this goes out mainly to the family and friends of our brother David. We all must be part of the servant ministry of Jesus Christ. And by doing so, we must reach out to those and touch others that we may come into contact with. My friend, I urge you to extend it wherever you go. In whatever situation of life you may find yourself in, regardless to what the journey may bring to you, whether it's hard or easy, extend that winning side to others, and others will be able to feel the touch of Christ using you as a channel. My friends, I urge you, fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Amen.
On behalf of the parish family here, All Saints, I want to extend my deepest condolences to the family of our dear brother David, especially to his mom, Mary. I spoke to her, I think it was sometime over the weekend or last week. Pray that God will strengthen you at this time and give you that strength to continue the journey that he would have left. All of us on this earthly pilgrimage still have that journey to travel on. And may we, by the grace of God, be able to deal with it as it comes to us. May he rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. Let us all stand and reaffirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed, which can be found in your booklet. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
for the prayers of the church. At this time, we pray for those who mourn. Pray that God will continue to give them his strength, power. We commemorate the departed soul of our brother David. After each bidding, your response will be, hear our prayer. Let us pray with confidence to God, our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy, may we be strengthened in our faith. Live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son. And be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy, show your mercy to the dying. Strengthen them with hope. And fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, we commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled. And we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age. Pray that we share with them in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Give us this day our daily bread. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, the evil we have done and the good we have failed to do, and strengthen us to follow the steps of your Son in a way that leads to the fullness of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us commend our brother David Andrew to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, By your mighty power, you have given us new life in Christ Jesus. We entrust David Andrew to your merciful keeping. In the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us, and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. Let us all stand and sing the hymn, How Great Thou Art, and sing the wondrous love of Jesus. During these hymns, a collection will be taken, which will be used for the continual work here at All Saints. How great thou art. Donat Demetus.
Thank you. of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. Whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Our God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins. At our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, O Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother David Andrew. And we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. We beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother David Andrew and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants, who having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage. They may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Unto God's most gracious mercy and protection we commit him. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious unto him. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon him and give him his peace, now and forevermore. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, let the earth hear Him. Oh Lord, support us all the day long, the troublous life. Till the shades lengthen and the evening comes, the fever of life is over and our work is ended. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant unto his servant David a holy rest and peace at the last through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Go in peace, continue to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen. May he rest in peace.
Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. We agree. Amen.